Hey guys, EDDBUD here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I've got a very quick kind of initial review of a new heart rate monitor that I've picked up from Polar. It's the OH1 Plus. So I've done a couple of initial runs using the heart rate monitor now. Very impressed with the results. I'll give you a bit more information when I get back to the studio. Sanctuary of the shoe zone. Beast and I have headed back up here. There's people sort of downstairs and all sorts of stuff going on. We're here in the warm, out of the howling wind that's currently going around the suburban streets. So I purchased the Polar OH1 Plus on recommendation from the Jedi Master, Mr. Kafuzi. If you haven't checked out Kafuzi's recent endeavours examining math tone training and kind of utilising that within his training for the marathon distance, then what have you been doing? Get over there right now, seriously, and check out some of Kafuzi's videos. He's been documenting some of the equipment he's been using and also how that training's been impacting upon his fitness. Really, really interesting stuff. I think he's really kind of dedicated himself towards it. And I think sometimes when people review stuff, the reviews go on maybe sort of a run or something, or they've tried something occasionally. Kafuzi's been really, really dedicated towards this training method, and I take my hat off to him. Not that I'm wearing a hat right now, but if I was, I would be taking it off to him, yes. All right, let's get on with this. Enough of this buffoonery. So Kafuzi's recommended this unit to me after I've been finding that the optical heart rate sensor on my Apple Watch just isn't really useful. It's just not really accurate enough. I'm getting really inconsistent results all the time, and it does seem to be heavily affected by different weather conditions. I just can't really put any faith into the data that the Apple Watch heart rate sensor produces. So it's a simple old setup here with the OH1 Plus. It's got a strap which is very, very sort of adjustable. I've not got a lot of upper body strength, I don't think. Apart from playing guitar, that's pretty much the only strength and training I do in terms of my arms. Maybe I should do some more, I don't know. But it's very adjustable. I found it perfect really straight out of the box. And the sensor itself is probably a few 10 pence coins kind of stacked together, maybe about 4 or 5 coins high. And it's a very simple affair. If there's a power button, I'm gonna switch it on right now, and you can see it's glowing there. And it's a long press just to turn the thing off again. The sensor itself can sit in this little charging pod, which can be powered by USB, so you can utilize this also to get some of the information from the sensor, because it can be used as a kind of standalone device, as well as something that you might want to attach up to other fitness training devices that you may have. So I had to give this device a bit of a charge actually when I first took it out of the box. I was a little bit disappointed that it wasn't charged up. It did have to seem to have some power. It wasn't completely out. And I also did have to pair it with my phone to sort of seem to initiate it. It didn't seem to want to attach to the Bluetooth on my Apple Watch until I'd actually paired it up with my phone. It's kind of strange. I don't know if that's some sort of bug or it's just something that's affected me personally, but it was a bit strange. Once it had though, it was dead easy to set it up within the Apple Watch. So the Apple Watch kind of utilizes the OH1 Plus while it's switched on and it's connected to it. Otherwise, it defaults back to the optical heart rate sensor that's built into the watch itself. So I placed a strap onto the left part of my upper arm around here. I didn't really kind of think about it too much. I just placed it on there with the sensor pointing down, switched it on, and headed out on a training run of about 7.5 miles. It was a fartlek session with about 4 miles at a pace between somewhere like 6:30 and 8 minutes per mile. I think the fartlek needed to be about 30 minutes. I think that's why I'm down on my training plan. And I think that part of the run came in at around about 7 minutes 10 seconds per mile. I kept the rest of it to a much more manageable pace between about 7 minutes 40 per mile and 8 minutes per mile. So after the run, on kind of examining the data, examining the heart rate information that it had recorded, I could see straight off the bat that this was given a much more accurate and reliable reading of my heart rate over the course of the run. I examined a little bit into the heart rate app on the Apple Watch, and it seems to kind of update or at least get a heart rate reading every 2 or 3 seconds. When I attach the OH1 Plus to the Apple Watch, it seemed to be updating on a much more rapid, more frequent basis. Just seems like it's given a more realistic interpretation of my heart rate. I can remember a few times, certainly on some more testing efforts over the last few months, of looking down at my watch and kind of seeing some readings that just seemed bizarre and just completely off and left field. They weren't right at all. So certainly this is going to be a useful acquisition, and one which is going to present me some more usable data. I used the Vaporfly 4% Flyknit, purchased these back in, I think it was December of 2018, and I think they're now up to about 180 miles. I'm just starting to feel that they're bottoming out a little bit. They don't feel quite as fresh, quite as bouncy. They don't seem to have quite that kind of snap to them as they used to. Now, I've certainly done a few repairs over the last few months with these. It's mainly in the foam back here where it's starting to deteriorate a little bit. The pods aren't loose by any means, these rubber sections, but I can feel that the shoe is not quite what it used to be. So I think it's probably round about time to retire these, even for those sort of tempo efforts, the interval type efforts that I'm going to be doing with training over the next 12 months or so. I think I've got better options now, so I think I may well be time to retire, you old friends. We had some good times together. On a second run with the Polar OH1 Plus, I used the Adidas Ultra Boost, just headed out for a very, very easy 3 miles, keeping the heart rate nice and low. I found it's much easier to kind of look down, quickly see the heart rate and realize just how fast or slow I might be going and make adjustments on the fly. These are working out really nicely now. Only a little bit of insole movement where I've made that customization to them. But the midsole seems to have broken a little bit. The popping, I didn't experience any of that today. And even though I was moving a lot faster than I probably should have been for an easy day, the shoe felt really great. So I'm glad I managed to get some miles into these. And now it's onwards and upwards to 100 miles for that sort of full review. Again, after that second run, looking at the analysis of the heart rate, the readings are more dense. They're more frequent, certainly more reliable. You can see kind of a progression there. The changes are smoother. You could even pick out really during the fartlek session I did the day before exactly where that happened, where the effort increased, where my heart rate increased. I think I've just got a lot more confidence in those readings now. I know just how hard I was working at certain times, and certainly looking at my heart rate, I can probably hit things a little harder and probably push that threshold a little more. I think buying this heart rate sensor, it wasn't just really me that wanted to do it. I kept getting a lot of feedback from other Strava users saying, you know, that your heart rate looks good, but some, you know, some weird stuff going on there. What's all that about? Is it really that good? Well, actually, just a couple of runs, I can already see that some of those spurious readings were perhaps making me think I was working a little bit harder than I was. As I mentioned earlier, this sensor can actually record just on its own as a standalone device. So what I might try to do over the next couple of weeks is to record a couple of runs and then pair those up with the data that I get from the Apple Watch heart rate sensor and see just, you know, what the differences are. Certainly I can see the Polar OH1 Plus is going to give me denser, more frequent readings as opposed to the sometimes spurious and weather kind of influenced readings that the Apple Watch produces. Just to make it very clear, I bought this device myself. It's not something that's been sent to me. This is very much a review from the heart. Certainly really, really good to get out there in the daylight for a change. I've been doing a lot of training in the dark, in the mornings, in the evenings. Certainly in the UK, it's quite tough if you're doing a 9-to-5 day job and you want to get out and run with your GoPro, with your Insta360 or something, you're gonna get low light footage every time. But it was good to get out today. I think I certainly stood out on that grey, dank Saturday morning with the old Nike flash coat and the Hygi headband to keep the old noggin nice and warm. I know some of you really enjoy my kind of running music album kind of reviews, or at least very short kind of updates. So I've got a couple of those for you today. Oh, a long time ago, I had a copy of this album, Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. This was certainly his sort of debut album, as it were, as a solo artist, and it's a great album. I remember driving around delivering wedding cakes and stuff like that in an old Nissan Micra, and I unfortunately left the CD I had of this album in a car when I sold it. I always kick myself. So recently I purchased it again so I can listen to this fantastic album. I do recall particularly like Everybody's on the Run, Fire the Gun, Stop the Clocks, that's a great track as well. I do particularly like Noel Gallagher's solo stuff. I think it's just got a little more subtlety, certainly, than some of the latter Oasis releases. Another album that I spotted recently and I couldn't help but pick up and have again been listening to on my runs, on my training, is that of Radiohead's In Rainbows. As you probably know, if you've heard this before, The Reckoner is a brilliant track, and Videotape as well, another awesome tune from Radiohead. They've produced so many good albums, so many sort of different albums. I really, really love stuff that Tom York's produced for running. It just always sounds really rhythmic. There's always a very kind of mechanical feeling, mechanical and organic feeling to the sounds. And certainly this album is no exception to that. So I've really been enjoying this one. Nice to have it on vinyl as well. There's certain albums that I listen to a lot, and I do like having a vinyl copy to listen to whilst I'm playing a little bit of billiards. If you have a separate heart rate monitoring device, please do comment below with your experiences in using it. And if you've also had any success with optical heart rate sensors on your watches, on your fitness devices, please let me know as well. I'm really keen to get a kind of global picture about what people are using out there to kind of monitor their heart rate, monitor their running efforts. Many, many thanks for watching. I do appreciate it. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. My name's EDDBUD, and I'll be seeing you.